Good day, everyone, and welcome to the Flux Media Channel. In the clip of today, we're going to be talking to you about moving the parameters straight from the encoder section of the console, and obviously with the result of seeing those movement into SPAT Revolution software. So we've talked about encoder and moving parameters. Well, let's turn to the actual module on the console. Let's now zoom in on the encoder section plugin control on the actual console. We're actually looking at the SPAT send and all the parameters right now. On the top here, on the top left, gain value. If you look at the SPAT Revolution software right now as well, you'll be seeing that I can actually change the gain on the actual source object right there. Right next to it, global time. So this is a global time value for all parameters available for the source. And when we activate this time link function, meaning that the timing for all the parameters is on, when we link this, all actual parameter changes will get executed in the specific time. Right now, let me move on to the first radiation parameter called the azimuth. If I'm actually moving the azimuth, as you can see, I did the move, but you know it's taking some time to do it, and this is because of our 1.5 second setting on the global time. Azimuth, moving the azimuth on the object. Elevation, this is the elevation from my listening position below or above my head. And that becomes obviously very interesting when we've got multiple layer of speakers working on the dome, or having some sort of a top speaker, or even in a binaural experience. Third one here, another important one, is what we call the distance, is how close or how far the object, the source, is from you. Below this, azimuth time, elevation time, distance time, this we're back to duration, to timing here. If the time link function is off, now you can actually use these individual parameters, one for the azimuth, the elevation, the distance, well, actually all parameters as we're gonna go through the pages, have a timing value. So you can have a specific timing for the azimuth, for example, moving in 1 second, while the distance will move in 10 seconds. So you get a way smoother transition on a distance change. When you're recalling snapshot, becomes very interesting. Below this, yaw, pitch, and aperture, three other settings of the radiation. The yaw is actually, is the object pointed at me? Or no, the object is actually pointing at the opposite direction. So you can decide, you know, where the object is facing, really. Pitch, pitching up or pitching down. Well, I've done the reverse, but you get the concept. You know, where are we actually pitching the sound? So the pitch parameter right there. Aperture. Aperture is how open, right? Right, as I'm turning the aperture all the way up, I'm actually exciting the room in, you know, in all directions. And this is because the aperture is at the maximum. While if I actually close this, I get something very, very directional. Again, if I use this with the yaw, pointing at me or not pointing at me. Timing values are on the bottom. Next page. The next page has rotation X, Y, Z. So these are X, Y, Z parameter changes for our actual object. If you rather use X, Y, Z, it's available to you right there. Let's move to the third page right away. We actually find the XYZ again with their timing value. But below this is optional parameters, spread, Doppler effect, air absorption, drop lug, pan reverse, early, radius, and drop factor. You can find all these parameters in the option section of the actual object. Next page, the reverb page. Reverb on, reverb off. So I'm putting the reverb on or I'm putting the reverb off. And then you have, and that comes from some very interesting research from the IR cam, you actually have what we call perceptual factors. So instead of actually setting a reverb with, you know, traditional reverb settings, you're actually talking about something, anyway, as far as I'm concerned, that makes more sense. We're talking about presence, we're talking about warmth and brilliance. Those are three the parameters right there. Below this is the room presence. So here on the original, on the presence on top, we're talking about the presence about the actual sound itself. And then we're talking about the room presence in the mix. The running reverberance and feeling of envelopment are other settings right there. Very interesting to play with. Last but not least is another page which gives you some EQ functions. We have axis EQ, so on axis, and the omni, which is the room. So you have a little EQ actually to adjust both sounds, the direct sound and the omni, right there for you. Let's now do this with some audio so we can have a feeling for all this.
I am the key to the
love. You're currently listening to the acoustic guitar. We're solo on acoustic guitar. You obviously hear some bleeding on the vocal. We're actually soloed on that acoustic guitar. It is selected on the Spat Revolution software. Now you're hearing this dry. If we actually fire some reverb a bit on this, give you a feeling, and that's the room concept and the reverb concept in Spat Revolution. Just to quickly give you an example of room presence, if I'm starting to fire some room presence, I'm actually going to get the room feeling of right now happening. And these are the perceptual factors of the reverb. Very interesting to work with your reverbs on Spat Revolution. Now let's actually move to radiation. Gets more interesting there. We have a 1 second time on the global. Let's put the time link function. We have a gain of -6. Let's leave it at this for now. And let's move an azimuth. All right, you'll get the feeling of the azimuth moving left to right. That was quite quick. All right, moving this left to right. Let's go back to the other side. Oh, over there. And obviously, the timing value becomes interesting here to give you a bit of smoothness on that movement. Distance, the object's going to get closer to us, or actually going to go further away. All right, you're feeling this. Concept of distance. And the other one would be elevation, if we move the elevation. Now, this obviously gets more interesting with the Zenith or top speaker, but you actually may feel it a bit with the binaural as well. So this is it. This gives us a nice experience on what's going on here. Obviously, we could be digging in and playing with the yaw, the pitch, the aperture. But the idea was to give you kind of a feeling of this plugin integration and how the page encoder page control that gives you right control right on your console in your snapshots, moving those objects into the space. And this is it for a session for today. Hope you enjoyed it and stay tuned for more. If you do have any question about this actual integration or any technical question about what we're showing here, feel free to hit us with an email and we'll be happily responding to you as fast as possible. In the meantime, enjoy your immersive audio.